Just bear with us briefly and turn in your Bibles also again with us to the book of Galatians. We are going to close out what we was talking about last week, the spirit of addiction. Amen. Addiction is a spirit, and we went through, amen, the categories, amen, dealing with that spirit. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, Galatians 5:20, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like. Of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do these things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. We are going to be dealing with the lower verse, verses 22 through 26 this afternoon. And it reads thus: but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. I'm going to ask the children to please move on the back row. Amen. Out of the way. Thank you. It goes on to say, meekness, temperance, against such there is no law. Verse 24. And they that are Christ have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vain glory, provoking one another, envying one another. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we go into your word,
yes,
help us, Lord God, to know how to deal and combat the enemies, Lord God, and the things that he is bringing into the life of this thy believers. Help us to walk in victory in your word, and help us to understand that in your word, through faith, is the only way we can walk in that victory. Amen. Somebody shout amen.
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 And amen. Today I would like to deal with Paul's writing to the Galatians, chapter 5, Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 through 26. We're going to go into part 2 of the spirit of addiction, and part 2 is how to get free from the spirit of addiction. How to get free from the spirit of addiction. It's one thing to tell me about my problem, but can you also tell me how to be free of my problem or come out of my problem? Can you, amen, tell me the remedy of, amen, situations that I can get, amen, free or from under the bondage of any kind of spirit or any kind of stronghold that is in my life? The world tries to, amen, promote many types remedies that people can get free from strongholds. But if you don't be careful, amen, as soon as they come from under those that are administering or trying to teach you how to come out, as soon as you get away from them or out of their program, you find out that people, amen, there is an alarming rate of people that fall back right back into the same problem again.
That's right.
Right now I was listening, amen, on one of the public radio stations, how there is one, amen, city or a county somewhere here in the United States that is now, the young people are being taken, amen, under the spirit of opioids. They are, amen, addicted. A number of people are addicted to heroin, young people. Mm-hmm. Amen. Right now there is an epidemic of heroin addiction. In our last, amen, text we was talking about last Sunday, you know, there are certain situations that causes us to fall under these different spirits, amen. Sometimes, amen, we just hang around with people, amen, and they're influenced by these spirits and they get on us. Sometimes we go places where we know we ain't got no business going. Amen. We get caught up amen, in certain things, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. These spirits jump on us.
Amen.
Mind ourselves, amen, spending the next 5 to 10 years trying to come out from under our habit.
Yeah.
Well, we thought we was having a good time.
Amen.
And we tried something, whether it was a pill, whether it was a shot, or somebody put something in your drink. We come out the 5 to 10 years trying to come out, amen, of that situation. And sometimes, amen, we voluntarily go and do stuff. Amen. We know we ain't got no business going.
Amen.
Can I get some help in here?
Amen.
On the way back home, amen, we get stopped by the police.
Mm-hmm.
On the way back home, amen, we run off the street, hit a tree.
Yes.
On the way back home, we have a flat tire. Amen. Just so happened it was raining, we slipped off the road. Amen.
Yes.
Got in an accident. Some people, amen, have gotten comas. They have, amen, broken limbs. Amen. They've gotten situations where they can't work anymore. Amen. And it caused a toll on their families. Amen. You see, because you're not just living for you.
Amen.
I have a son, 10-year-old son. Amen. I got to live for him now.
That's right.
I'm 53 years old today. I can't live for myself anymore.
That's right.
I got to live for him.
Amen.
Amen. To make sure, amen, I do my best. Amen. And my wife, she lets me know all the time, you have to do what you have to do, amen, for him, because you're a man and he's a boy. You're pouring into him.
Amen.
Amen. He needs his father. Amen.
Amen.
So I can't just go where I want to go.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. I can't just do what I want to do.
Yes.
Oh, I can't just, amen, have fun with the fellas anymore. But, amen. And do all that stuff. Amen.
Yes.
At this time in my life, Steve, we go through what is called, amen, Mike, a midlife crisis, amen. Hallelujah. We want to do things, amen, to try to be like that guy back there,
amen.
Stay young, amen. But we need to understand that we have to, amen, get it in our hearts and in our minds that just because something is new, that does not mean I have to try it to make myself feel good.
That's right.
Make myself feel young or loved or whatever I'm trying to achieve. The only thing that God requires you to do, amen, is to love and praise him.
Yes.
That's why we are put on the face of this earth. Amen. To do his will. To find out what his will for in our lives. The most comprehensible solution that I could think of to be free from the spirit of addiction is to completely take upon oneself the character of the opposite spirit of that addiction. Why? Because the Bible tells us that two cannot walk together except they agree. Amen.
That's right.
Two cannot walk together except the opposite of faith is fear. For example, if you're going to pray in faith, why are you going to fear?
That's right.
If you're going to fear, walk in fear, why are you going to pray in faith? Amen. Hallelujah. The opposite of one is the other. Amen.
Amen.
If you're going to pray, pray in faith and believe God. Don't have fear. If you're going to walk in fear, then why are you praying? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Either do one or the other.
Amen.
Sweet and bitter water can't come out of the same fountain.
Amen.
Either water is going to be healthy or it's going to be poison.
Amen.
Oh my God. Hallelujah. Right now, in one of our main cities, amen, one of the major energy suppliers had coal ash ponds, and some of the water leaked out into the main water system, and it's been leaking for years. Amen. Hallelujah. And people are being poisoned.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking that the water is good, people are being poisoned. They're being poisoned, amen, not because they know it, amen, or they were being poisoned, and they come to the realization that they were being poisoned, not because they took the water and had it chemically analyzed, but because they seen the manifestations of the effect that, of the water that they was drinking.
Mm-hmm.
One young woman, she looking up, was her community, said, in my community, I've seen somebody over here get sick. Somebody down the road gets sick, and somebody over, my neighbor over here got sick. She began to wonder, after so many years, why people in this particular neighborhood get sick. Then she said her brother got sick, and he died of a tumor. Amen. Something's going wrong. The water's been, is poisoned.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And it will have an adverse effect over time. What are you saying, Pastor? I'm saying that you can get into some of these addictions and you can enjoy them now. But over time, they will have an adverse effect on your life.
Yes.
And when we see that in the word that God said, be not deceived, God is not mocked, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Right in the next chapter, chapter 6, verse 8, it says this, what you do now is going to have an adverse effect on you later on. And when, amen, it has an adverse effect on you, amen, we want a mighty miracle from God. But God revealed unto me, sometimes you can come to the altar and you can ask him for forgiveness. Amen. But he may tell you the same thing he told Paul. My grace is sufficient for thee. Amen. God allows you to see the problem and allows you to get right now. Amen. But you shall die later. You may die from the cause. You may die, amen, from the adverse effects. Prayer may not, amen, God may, it may not be God's will to heal you. Lord, have mercy. Isn't that very, amen, shocking to some of us? Oh, my God, no, God don't heal everybody. But he do save everybody. If you want to be saved, you can be saved. Amen. You may die, go to heaven. You saved. Hallelujah. But you may not have gotten healed. Amen. Do you see what I'm saying? The same principle applies in the spirit realm. The spirit of addiction cannot maintain a hold on your life if you repent and submit yourself to the Spirit of God. Because they won't dwell, amen, together. They can't dwell together. Galatians 5:22, amen, reveals unto believers the manifestations of the Spirit of God. These manifestations are also manifested in the life of every believing Christian. Everybody is saying that they are a Christian, but everybody is not believing, amen, to the point of receiving the manifestations of the Spirit of God in their life. It's one thing to say you are a Christian, it's another thing to be a Christian. Amen?
Amen.
It's one thing to say, amen, that you are a believer, but it's another thing to walk in the light of a believer. Because it's going to have adverse effects on you, amen. If you are saying that you are a believer, but not walking according to the word of God, then you're not a believer, you are a hypocrite. Hallelujah. I said, you are a hypocrite. On the other hand, when you trust in the word of God, I don't care if you was a prostitute, if you was a drug dealer, if you was the biggest thief in the city of Catawba. When you change your life and repent, amen, God transforms your mindset. You are not, amen, a thief or robber or whatever you was anymore. You are a Christian. I don't care how many people know you from what you used to do. Did y'all get that?
Amen.
There are people in the church saying they're Christian, but they ain't living a life worth nothing. There are some people, amen, that you know that wasn't living a life worth nothing, living a life from a gutter, but they trusted, believed in God's word, came to Christ, gave their heart to Christ, and the only thing you know them from is what they used to be, but God has made them, amen, according to his word, amen, to walk in the newness of life, and they are now a new creature in Christ Jesus, and now they are trusting in the word of God, blood water, blood water, shabbat, pulling up the blood of spirit. I can't worry about how you used to know it. How do you know it now? They are walking according to the word of God. Come on, put your hands together and shout
hallelujah.
Everyone who believes in Christ must believe in faith. By grace are ye saved through faith according to Ephesians 2 and 8. This thing is by faith. Somebody say it's by faith. Tell somebody else it's by faith. Tell someone again it's by faith. Hallelujah. You got to walk by faith. I walk by faith, not by sight. You got to walk by faith. You have to believe God by faith. God wants you to come out of our in his blood through faith. God can bring you out of any spirit of addiction by faith. And you can walk, amen, in the newness of life by faith. But you must receive, amen, the Spirit of God on the inside. Because you cannot have, amen, a lifestyle walking in Christ, doing what his word says,
have the power to own your own. It's in your own flesh that people try to walk as Christians, but God said you can't do it by the flesh. It must be by the Spirit. You have to have the Spirit on the inside. It's the Spirit that gives us the power to be great exploits. It's the Spirit that gives us the authority. Amen. To put our foot on the level here. It's the Spirit that gives us the ability to be more than conquerors. Of a spiritual life or a spirit-filled life. In other words, walking according to the will of God.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Galatians 5 verse 32 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is first love, joy, then peace, long-suffering, goodness, gentleness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. I don't care if it's the law of man or it's the laws in the spirit realm, because there are laws in both realms. The Bible says in the spirit realm, whatsoever a man sows, that shall be also reaped. Amen. Looking at the word, it is a promise and it is a command. Amen. God commands you to sow something. Hallelujah. And if you sow it, go and get it. Amen. Some fruit from it. Amen. Now, the thing about it is, the kind of seed that you put in the ground could be a good seed or it could be an evil seed. Oh my God. The word of God is so true. It's so profound. It's so correct that if you put an evil seed in the ground, it's going to come up and it's going to bear fruit. Hallelujah. That's what the word said. Whatsoever that sower, that shall it also be. So you have to get in the word of God and find out what you need to sow. Some of y'all need to stop sowing stuff. Amen. Because it's bearing bad fruit. If you plant one grain of corn, it's going to produce a stalk that has several ears, that has hundreds of grains. Then he looked at it and said, oh, that's good. I want him to look at me, man, and say, that's my son. say something good about me. Hallelujah. Bible says blessings will overtake you. Blessings haven't even caught up with you yet. Some of the blessings God has you ain't caught up with you yet. That blessings will overtake you.
Yes, they will.
But the stuff that you're planting caused those blessings to be eat up so quick.
That's right.
Oh my God.
Jesus.
Called those blessings. Amen. To be used up so quick. Galatians 5, verse 22 deals with the life of a believer and the manifestations of the fruit of the Spirit. In order to, amen, walk according to the Word, live in the Word, God also wants you to walk in the Word. Amen. Paul tells us this, amen, in verse 25. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. If we say we are Christians, let us do things, amen, that promote a lifestyle of Christ.
Amen.
Did you get that?
Amen.
If we say we are believers, let us also continue to walk, amen, as believers, amen, speaking things out of our mouths that are positive and is conducive with the Word of God, amen, that connects our relationship with God as believers. You cannot be a believer in the Word of God speaking negative all the time. You cannot be a believer in the Word of God speaking doubt all the time. You cannot be a believer in the Word of God, amen, and speak, amen, doubtful things all the time. I'll never make it. I don't know if I ever, amen, get out of this one. I don't know if I ever get over this addiction. You know what? I tried to come out, but I might as well go ahead and just don't worry about it. Hallelujah. You ain't never going to come out talking like that.
Amen.
How about saying, you know, I'm under this thing now, but God's going to bring me out. I'm coming out of this. I know I'm not where I should be right now. And that's how far some of us get. I know I'm not what I want to be, but I'm not what I used to be. Amen. And that's as far as we get. Amen. That's as far as you stay. I'm not what I want to be. You never get to where you want to be. You never get to where God called you to be. You never get to where God said you should be. You stay right there hoping that I know I'm not what I ought to be. Thank God I'm not what I used to be. Why don't you say, I know I'm not what I want to be right now, but I'm doing better. I'm going to get to where God wants me to get. I'm not good at that anymore. The reason why I'm not what I used to be is because I'm walking away from that stuff and I'm walking into my destiny. I'm walking into a better place. Yes. Amen. I know that, amen, we don't have all the finances right now. Because I want to do what I want to do and I use them and messed up with gambling.
Yes.
That can be an addiction.
Amen.
Yes. Maybe I want to use the most money on the scratch off tickets. I know I did.
Yeah,
but if you forgive me this time, manifestations of what God took Jacob.
Amen.
Manifested throughout all 12 of his sons as the nation of Israel. And that nation is still prominent on the earth today. Spirit of God and the spirit prediction can't dwell in the same place at the same time.
That's right.
Out of all of the manifestations of the spirit, fruit of the spirit, love, joy, peace, long suffering, goodness, meekness, temperance. The one that I chose out, the one that popped off the page at me to combat the spirit of addiction, the spirit of faith.
Yes.
You have to have faith in God. Hallelujah. No law can condemn one with the fruit of the Spirit. Paul said when you get the fruit of the Spirit, or when you get the manifestation of the Spirit, the anointing of God in your life, amen, it brings you out from the curse of the law. And it brings you, urges you in to the law of grace. God's unmerited favor. I know I don't deserve it.
Yes.
God's going to give it to you anyway.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And when you receive His Spirit on the inside, it comes by faith. The law, any law, cannot condemn the righteousness of God. And righteousness only comes how?
By faith.
Therefore, faith is the word of God. Amen. It is that manifestation of God's Spirit that opposes any addiction in your life. Any kind of addiction in your life. Whatever the addiction is that's in your life, the Spirit of God by faith can bring you out. Amen. If you want to get the spirit of addiction out of your life, spirit of addiction also carries with it habits. Amen. If you want to get habits out of your life, spirit of addiction also carries with it dependence. If you want to get the spirit of dependency out of your life, whatever your dependency is upon, amen. I'm breaking this word down. The Spirit of God can bring you out of that spirit of dependency. The spirit of God, the spirit of addiction, also carries with it the spirit of dependence. The spirit of dependency, spirit of dependence. We talked about this last week. The spirit of dependence is those drugs. If it was drugs, over-the-counter medication. Yeah. Some folks are dependent on over-the-counter medication. They're not illegal. You can go to the drugstore, you can buy them. They're legal. You don't have to have a prescription. My God, if you were dependent on soap, that if you didn't have them, you'd go crazy. You know you're dependent on something.
Yes.
If you don't have it, you go crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I have an aunt, had an aunt, amen, she was dependent on Coca-Cola's. She had to have that Coca-Cola.
Right.
If she didn't have that Coke, get out of her way. Don't talk to her. Don't come asking her no questions. Give me my Coke. Did you not know that back in the day, they used Coke or Cola to be the conduit in which they put the medicine cocaine in?
Mm-hmm.
To make it easy, I guess, for you to drink down. They put cocaine in the Coca-Cola for medicinal purposes. So when they took the cocaine, which is an addictive substance, out of the Coke, the drink remained, I suppose. It's speculated, because we're still drinking it today.
Amen.
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 So what are you saying? I'm saying there are some things, amen, that you're dependent on, amen. You may not deal with the substance per se, but there is a conduit that brings you into relation with the substance, or to get the substance that you're dependent on. So through the conduit of being able to go buy it over the counter, now you go to your doctor.
Yes, sir.
And you say, I need this.
Yes, sir.
Because if I don't have this, I just
doctor prescribes you this. And you get hooked on it. Amen. How is that possible? Well, it's simple. It's the spirit. Wine coolers. Nothing wrong with wine coolers. Yes, it is. It's got alcohol in it. It's alcohol. Wine coolers ain't doing it no more. Budweiser. You know what? I went in the store and I see a joker. He grabbed a big old 24 pack. Oh, he had a big old thing. And they said, well, I got to about drink all of this to get a buzz. Mm-hmm. Amen. Some people, they just drink one. Mm-hmm. Some people got to drink the whole pack. And they just sit. And they just drink and drink and drink. I tried that with water. I couldn't get 2 8-ounce glasses down. I don't see how in the world they drink all of that beer. Just drink and drink and drink. Then one guy, he let me know how he can do it. What goes in must come out. And that's all I do. It goes in and comes out. In and comes out. Until you get a buzz. You put your body through that. That cycle. Amen. What kind of cycles are we putting our bodies through? Because we want to satisfy what we want to satisfy. And that's not good enough to go to something strong with us. Jim Beam. Alright? Amen. When that don't work, they go to something strong. Amen. Hallelujah. What I'm saying is, I don't care if it's the spirit of God or if it's the spirit, amen, of the flesh. You'll never be satisfied. When you hunger and thirst after righteousness, mm-hmm. that hunger should grow more and more and more and more. If you are hungry and thirst after the things of the world, amen, that hunger is going to grow more and more and more and more. Amen. But the two spirits combat one another. The spirit of faith. Faith. Faith is a spirit. Mm-hmm. Am I talking to somebody?
Amen.
Faith, said it with me. Faith,
faith
is a spirit.
Is a spirit.
Say it again, faith.
Faith
is a spirit.
Is a spirit.
Galatians 3:13-14. And if you would just give me just a few more minutes, turn there with me, please. Promise of the Spirit through faith. Galatians 3:13-14. Can I read it in your hearing right quick?
Yeah.
Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. He became a curse for us, that by faith we can receive life in him. Verse 14, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, amen, becomes our Abraham. That we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. Jesus became a curse for us. Everything that he had, now we have. Amen. All the righteousness he became, he took what we have, had the curse and the judgment, and gave us what he had. The righteousness, justification, sonship. God gave us all of that through faith, through his spirit. We have it through faith. Faith is the spirit. Romans 14:23. What is not of faith is sin. Romans 14:23. What is not of faith is sin. Did you get that?
Amen.
2 Corinthians 5:7. We walk by faith, not by sight.
Yes.
We need to understand that in the Word of God, amen, everything. Everything that is not in God's word, amen, to promote us to the promise of God, amen, will bring damnation to our soul if we walk in that thing. Mm-hmm. On the opposite end, everything in the word of God that causes us to walk, amen, to his promise, amen, will help us by faith. I want everybody to stand in this building.